Rufus and Thorn found the mysterious bag and fled through the magical portal. Meanwhile, Ceridwen and Felkor are heading north in search of the third magical item.
Yay!
Finally!
After a long day's trek, they set up camp.
What?
Come on!
When are we gonna get to see some action?
Patience, Felkor. Only fools rush in. They are building a fire.
So, where to next?
Well, the minstrel's song told us to head north, where a familiar face holds the key.
Familiar face? Crazy minstrel.
I'm kind of hungry. Why don't you grab some more wood for the fire, and I'll find us something to eat.
As you wish,
Your Highness.
Prithee there, young princess!
Okay, what does prithee even mean? I don't care. What do you want?
It would appear that Cupid's arrow has struck the elf. I thought you should know.
What? No, it hasn't. And how would you know?
Felkor like Ceridwen.
Shut up, idiot!
Pretty bad! Hello.
What are you doing here?
I come with but a humble message.
Speak it, don't sing it.
Yes, well... It would seem that the princess has become quite fond of you.
And?
Romantically?
What?
Yes.
No, she hasn't. Has she?
Ceridwen likes Felkor.
You got wood? I mean, sticks for the fire?
Yep. Food?
Yeah, you know, I'm actually not that hungry. I think I'm just gonna go to bed.
Yeah, me too.
Get up! Get up! Get up! Get up! Get up!
Thanks. Almost lost my cool way.
Perhaps I'll just put this away before somebody gets hurt.
Yeah, good move. What next?
Well, with night setting in and the temperatures freezing, Felkor and Ceridwen need to find a way to dry themselves before they freeze to death. What do you do?
Oh, man. Okay. Using the natural speed of my elven body, I run back and forth through the forest until my clothes are dry.
Oh, I know. Casting a spell of heating light, I create an orb that warms and dries me.
Roll for it. Botched, I'm afraid.
What does that mean?
It's just for body heat, so we don't freeze.
Yeah, totally. I know, right? I just wish there weren't so many pointy sticks out here in the forest. So, is that an elven thing? So, is this it?
What's with all this commotion?
Oh, we are brave adventurers on a quest to restore the kingdom to its rightful rulers.
Hey, haven't I seen you before? You look familiar.
Let me see. Have you been to the Bobble Marshes?
No.
The Snorkel Pits?
No.
The Windy City?
No.
You haven't been made to do one of those Elven Council Trials of Forgiveness, have you?
Yeah, that's it.
Oh, well, there you go. You sell your likeness rights to a bunch of creepy elves, and then young, bright-eyed elves stopping you on the streets, asking you stupid questions. Didn't I save you from an evil snorkel beast? Weren't you under attack by the ancient evil Chickle Spoodles? Are you my father? Oh, it never ends.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
Look, you haven't seen a powerful magical item anywhere around here, have you?
A what?
You know, like a sword or a shield or a...
Tea cozy? Are you not talking about my tea cozy, are you?
What?
Yes, it's my most prized possession. You can't have it. Besides, what would keep my tea warm?
That's it. I've had enough of this. I'm getting out of here. Come on, Seridwin.
Well, well, well. Look what we got here. I've been following you two for days. You see, I stumbled upon this here poster, and it seems Crizen wants you two dead or alive, but mostly dead.
We have to go through me first.
How about I go through her?
You love me.
What? No. What about the whole diving in front of the arrow thing?
The Elven Council. They told me to protect you.
So you don't?
No.
Oh. Well, thank God that's over with.
I am still dying.
Falcor, you have sacrificed yourself and proven to be a true elf.
Strangest dream. And you were there? And you were there? And... oh. Not a dream.
You're alive.
Oh, you saved my life. Here, take this. As a token of my thanks. It's my most prized possession. The greatest tea cozy in all the land.
Wait, this is your tea cozy? Never mind. Let's get out of here.